Hello YouTube, Chrome Freak here. We don't have a lot of time, so we gotta hurry here. I've got some PMs that people wanted wanted a detailed strip on the Kel-Tecs, P32, P3AT. And let's get started rather quickly because we don't have a lot of time. And it is safety checked and cleared, pull the trigger, 380, safety checked, cleared. Okay, let's do this quickly. Notch in the slide. It's a little bit easier if you pull it back far enough to clear that. Hold it with your finger. You could do it the other way, it's just a little easier to do it this way. I'll come right back all the way, pull the pin, slides out real fast. We're gonna go ahead and do a detailed strip on the slide. Bring it down just like normal. Barrel out, okay. There's gonna be a screw right here on the slide. That screw is gonna hold your extractor and your firing pin in. Take that screw completely out. Now when it comes from the factory, it's gonna have some Loctite on it. And it could be very difficult to get out. Be careful you do not strip this, the head of it. Pull this completely out. With it comes the plate. The plate holds the extractor in, right there. Fire pin, come right out. I'm not sure if you could see it. It's got a little U shape in the firing pin right here. Clean it off, put it right back in. Use your screwdriver, turn it to where you want it, because what's gonna happen is that little U groove that's shaped into that, your screw is gonna fit into that, and that's what holds the firing pin in. So you want that U pointing toward the hole here. Put the extractor in, it just falls right in, a little hole, it's pretty self-explanatory, just like a Glock or any other pistol. Okay, the plate has got a bend in it. What you want to do is you want to put the bend pointing up, so the pressure when you tighten the screw back down is pushing on the ejector, is what, why it's got that bend in there. Get the screw started and just tighten it all the way back down. Like I said, it comes from the factory with Loctite, so you want to tighten that down pretty good. I'm not going to do it right now because we don't have time, but it's back together, stripped and back together. Now we're going to work on the frame. We'll use the 380 for this one. Safety check again. We are clear. Pull the trigger. Bring it all the way back again, past the notch in the slide. Screwdriver behind it, pop the pin out. Now on the 380, you wanna leave it just like a Glock. You wanna leave it a little bit. You don't want it to come all the way back. Pull the pin out, slide comes right off, slide out of the way. Okay, let's real quick. The only differences in the frames on the 32 and the 380 is the ejector on 32 is actually built into the frame assembly. And on the 380, it's a piece that just comes out, just like that. Lay it off to the side, otherwise you're gonna be on your hands and knees looking for it, I promise you. Okay, there's two pins we're gonna knock out. One's at the very back, and one is right in front of the trigger, right there. I know you can't see them because they're very dark, but we'll see it. I know hammers usually and guns don't mix, but these are tight little pins, and you're not just gonna push them out. That's why I'm using this wood here. This root has got a notch in it, and I can knock the pins down through there safely without messing anything up. That's why I got that, if you're wondering. Okay, get this pin out. Okay, you just go ahead and push the pins completely out, let them fall. Okay, with that, you're gonna reach in. Actually, it'd be better, go ahead and fire. It don't matter if it slams, but you hold your finger in there, fire it, pull the trigger. Let the hammer come forward. Now we're gonna flip the gun over. On the black, just like the back of a Glock, this has got a hole and it's got a butt plug in it. The butt plug is holding the spring that goes to the hammer. So we're gonna have to pick it up, pull the plug out, give it a little twist, and we're gonna bring it over and let it fall down into the magwell. Once that happens, you can go ahead and pull the whole assembly right out. Whole assembly comes out. Now usually what happens is on this side, is your transfer bar or trigger bar. There's a little spring underneath, and in this case it didn't pop out. It usually does. I'm surprised it didn't. I go ahead and pop it out. There's the bar. That's your transfer bar right there. See, it's got a hole in one end. It fits on a little notch right there on the trigger. So go ahead and put that back on. Clean it up, do what you need to do. It fits right back on there. You gotta take this spring, go bring it all the way around, and the spring actually goes up underneath. So hard with this little stuff with me and my hands. It goes up underneath the bar and pushes the bar up, and that's what holds the bar into place. Okay, real quickly, inside the frame, your mag release, spring, pin, whatever you want to call it, it's right there. Right there, and you just want to make sure it is lower than the frame is. And this is your sear, right here in the back. And when we put this gun back together again, the sear, you're going to have to push up, spring loaded, and actually push it up forward out of the way to get the trigger behind it. And I'll show you what I'm talking about when we put it back together here. So what you're going to want to do is, because the plug hangs straight with the gun, you're going to have to go sideways like this, then turn it. Put your trigger in the hole and go ahead and pop it down and in. Okay. Now what you want to do is, you don't want to hook the plug up. The plug's going to be last. You want to reach in, pull your hammer all the way forward. Using your left hand or right hand, depending on what handed you are, you're going to hold that hammer forward. You're going to take a smallest screwdriver you can find, and we're going to need a light because it's hard to see. And you're going to reach between the frame and the housing, and you're going to reach in there, and you're going to push that sear forward. And it's very difficult to do. It's the most difficult part of the whole operation. And I got it. That's it. Everything's in there tight. Make sure the sear is where it's supposed to be, and it is not. It's still not in, so I'm glad I checked. Okay. There it is. Now it is. So it's kind of hard to do, trying to keep everything in a picture frame. And you know what? I'm not holding the bar forward. That's why I made a mistake. I'm sorry. Let's do it one more time. We got to hold that hammer forward, guys. You just seen me make a mistake. Hold that hammer forward, get that past it. Now we should be good if I didn't let it slip off. And we are. Now the sear is in front of the hammer, and I'm still holding that hammer forward. And you wanna hold that hammer forward still, because it's gonna help you push. You're gonna have to reach in down through the top of the magazine well and push that plastic piece out. Now when it comes out the top, you kinda wanna squeeze this together, and it'll help you hold it up here, and you're simply gonna put it into place and let it pop. This could be difficult right here. This could be things can get really frustrating with small guns, guys. It really can. Wow, that one went really easy, actually. I got lucky there, went kind of easy. I'm still holding the hammer forward, and you can see it's about to pop into place. Bang, it's in place. Okay, good to go. That was nice. Now we're gonna go ahead, you can see all our holes are lined up. Our pins are lined up. We're gonna go ahead, take a little ballistol on your finger, just a little. You don't need a lot of ballistol. It's great stuff. Coat the pins because it helps you take them out later. It really does. Just nice little easy. I don't like hammers and guns, but these little pins are really tight in this little frame. Let me just wipe this frame off. That's all I did was take it out to wipe it. Okay, guys, now we're ready. We're ready to go ahead and put the slide back on the pistol. And this is what, make sure I'm putting the right slide on. Oh, you know what I didn't do? I didn't put the extractor back on. This is where you could forget things and get a little hectic. Okay, we're gonna put the extractor right back in. Let's go ahead and cock the gun by hand, actually. Get the hammer out of your way. This slides right into place like a jigsaw puzzle. It fits right down in there. Take your time, make sure it's in there and ain't falling. Now we're gonna go ahead and it's on. Pull it back a little bit. You can actually see in there. There's a little spring in there that you're gonna have to defeat at first. Get the pin kind of going on an angle like this and push down on the little spring. Let me turn that off. Thank you. Okay, I messed it up now. Gonna push down on the spring to get it started, just like that. Now on the 380, you wanna leave it pulled back a little bit, just like a Glock. Bang, it's all the way in. We're gonna check it again. One more time for the heck of it. Okay, guys, that's it. I mean, it's that simple. It can get pretty frustrating the first time you do it, but take your time. I rushed here, I got 10 minutes, and it's not a lot, especially with these little pistols. They can really drive you crazy, especially if you got large size hands. But as you can see, you could do it, and you could take your gun apart. Just right here, real quick, just to show you. This holds the sear in, this pin. So you could take the sear out, but there's really no reason to. You can get in there and clean really nice without having to take it out. If you want to, you can. Once you got the frame out, pop that out. It's just a heck of a job to get it put back in, especially because there's not much room. And real quick, and we're done. For Mike, the firearms channel, I heard this is his favorite oil. So if he'll PM me with his address, I'll get this right out to him. Okay, Mike? I'm just kidding, guys. All right, YouTube, thank you so much. I thank all my subscribers and everybody who watches. Good night.